I'm Preetha Florina from Department of Botany. I'm dealing with environmental studies. Today's topic is about thermal pollution. So pollution basically is something which alters the originality of the nature's products. So since age-old time, we have heard about air, water, soil and noise pollution. But due to urbanization and various modern activities, we have come across a pollution which is nothing but thermal pollution. So in this class, we are going to understand the meaning, the cause, the effects, and also to take measures to prevent thermal pollution. So first, meaning. Meaning of thermal pollution is nothing but when you break the term thermal pollution, thermal refers to heat. So when it is released into a nature with a lot of heat, this kind of pollution activity is seen. Basically, thermal pollution is directly connected to water. So meaning, when it comes to the meaning, due to urbanization, again, because of industries and factories, the number of industry and factories activities has been increased. And usually factories and industries are built up close to the river bodies or even to the marine system. They draw the water from these system, and after the usage of the water, it is let down immediately back to the same water body which is there. And when it is going back to the same water body, the water which is there is being heated up and sent back to the water bodies. The meaning is simple, as we have told, when the normal water is being increased to different temperature, the entire system gets distracted or scattered. So the meaning is as clear that because of the heated water, automatically the ecosystem which is there in the river or the pond or the stream or any aquatic system or in the marine system is completely devastated. So what are the causes? The main causes is 100% we can tell it because of the industries and factories. Every person needs their basic needs, and factories or industries are much involved in providing basic needs to every human being living on the planet. So because of the enormous increasing activity of these industries and factories, what happens is the usage of water from these water bodies has been increased, and automatically the waste effluents, we call it as effluents, and the chemicals are directly released into the water bodies. Not only this, we have heard about hydroelectric power stations. Hydroelectric power stations also, when they produce electricity, a lot of heat is generated, and indirectly that water is also sent back to the water bodies. So the main cause here is about the industries and production of hydroelectric power stations. And not only this, earlier days we used to hear about different kinds of water plants. Now we have heard about nuclear power plants. Even nuclear power plants use water and give back the same chemicals and effluents back to the normal water. So main causes are the nuclear power plants, hydroelectric stations and factories and industries. So now we need to see the effects. What are the problems which are being faced by these kind of problems? So basically the main thing is the entire ecosystem which we call inside the pond system or the lake or any other water system is completely changed. Dissolved oxygen which is available in the water is completely becoming decreased because of the heated up water, one thing. Second thing is when the water level or the temperature level inside the water increases, automatically plants and animals cannot survive in this. So the lesser the ecosystem, the ponds and the rivers will be getting lesser and lesser day by day. This is one of the basic effects. The next effect which we see is because of the heated water, in the long run we can also notice you can also notice global warming, which rapidly heats up the earth, and this also can be the effect of the thermal pollution. Not only this, we also see a lot of other activities which is done by the human, that is throwing up even the waste products, can also cause about the effects for the thermal pollution. All these kinds of effects have been rapid, and it's been more and more in number due to the generation and various activities seen by the human things. So next we need to see how can we control it, or how can we prevent this kind of pollution. Basically, to control this kind of pollution, it's very hard. As we have told, urbanization and population increasing is become a major issue not only in developed but also in the developing countries. So how can you prevent, or how can we take measures to control this kind of pollution is, firstly, we need to have air coolants in the industries and factories, and also in the nuclear power plant stations, and also in the hydroelectric stations. Once you have an air coolant, the automatic water which is released back to the water bodies can be cooled, and they can be sent back to the water bodies. They can even also have huge containers to preserve this kind of usage water and unused water, so that it can be prevented in separate chambers, so that it can be reused again rather than taking up the fresh water from the water bodies. Not only this, you can also take measures to control the emission or release of chemicals directly into the water. This can be treated again with the help of chemicals and also with kind of big power plants, so that the entire water gets again treated up and finally can end up in less damage to the nature. So this is how we need to prevent, and most important is we need to give a lot of public awareness to people that because of certain pollutions like thermal pollution and other pollutions, we are facing a lot of issues. So this has to be prevented, and also this has to be controlled sooner as possible, so the further damages can be controlled. Thank you. So if you like this video, please share and subscribe to Teresian College. Thank you.